So we take that one, it means chemical analysis from the living tissue. We take one experiment on living tissue. On living tissue. For example, you take that small piece of leaf or liver, piece of leaf or liver. After that, so this small piece of leaf or liver weighing 8 weight. After that, then leaf is exposed to sun. After that, when the leaf is exposed to sun, so then water is evaporated from the leaf. It is become dry. So that is known as dry weight of mass. Dry weight of mass. So after then leaf is burned. Then leaf is burned. So in this, organic compounds are oxidized in the form of carbon dioxide and water vapor. That is the objective bit. When the leaf is burned, okay, so then organic compounds are oxidized in the form of vapor. This vapor having that carbon dioxide and water vapor. So it means small piece of leaf or liver, first one weighing that, so that is known as wet weight. After leaf is exposed to sun, then water is evaporated from the leaf, it is become dry, so that is known as dry weight of mass. Then leaf is burned, so organic compounds are oxidized, they are evaporated in the form of vapor. So they are known as carbon dioxide and water vapor. Okay, so that is that experiment. After that, the remaining part is known as that ash. Remaining leaf material is ash. So this ash having that inorganic elements. Okay, this inorganic elements are calcium and magnesium mostly, okay, and potassium and sodium is also there. Calcium, magnesium, potassium is mainly inorganic elements. So this inorganic elements are present in that ash. So that is the source of inorganic elements in a plant, that is known as that ash. It is the source of inorganic elements. Source of inorganic element is ash. Source of inorganic element, that is known as that previous medical bit. Okay. So important point. After that, some inorganic compounds are also present